a man wielding an axe attacks Chinese restaurants in New Zealand. Police said the 24-year-old man entered three Chinese restaurants and started randomly attacking people Monday night. Four people were injured. The suspect is under police custody and is due to appear in court Tuesday. Authorities did not give a motive for the attack. The National Historical Commission says a program is underway to bring back the youth's interest in studying the life of Philippine national hero Dr. Jose Rizal. Dennis Tato tells us more.
On the 162nd birth anniversary of the national hero of the Philippines, Senator Francis Tolentino and Calambas City Mayor Jose Rizal offered flowers at the monument of Dr. Jose Rizal. This was followed by a program at Rizal's Shrine, the house where the national hero was born. Every year, Rizal is remembered twice on the day of his birth and on the day he was executed. The news team asked the youth if they know our national hero in the age of social media.
Batang Rizal ako, yung pambansang bayan ng Pilipinas. Nag-aaral siya sa ibang bansa. Marami siyang pinag-aralan, marami siya ng iba't ibang lengguwahe.
May mga parts po na hindi. Kasi nalimutan na, matagal na po yung pinag-aralan.
According to Dr. Emmanuel Calairo, chairman of the National Historical Commission of the Philippines, or NHCP, they are already creating programs to restore the interest of the youth in studying the life of Rizal. And with technological advancement, social media is seen as an effective way to get the attention of the youth. NHCP gave the assurance that their content on social media will not be mixed with disinformation.
Meron tayong binubuo na communications team, no, at nakikipag-ugnayan din tayo sa ibang mga movement agencies, no, para coordinated lahat. Kasi sa panahon po ng fake news, napakahirap po ng ganito na hindi mo alam kung totoo ang tama na yung nag-aaralan mo, no. Pero with the directions coming from the National Historical Commission, makakaasa po kayo na primary source at the same time totoo po yung mga natututunan natin sa ating social media.
Siguro sa makabagong version, CHED, DepEd, magkaroon ng digital platforms para sa mga mithiin at mga advokasya ng ating pambansang bayan.
Mayor Rizal, a descendant of Rizal, is advocating for Calambas City to be declared as a historical district of the country. The Calambagong Buhayani Festival was held in the city on Monday. Large float that depicted the life of the national hero from his birth until his execution were included in the parade.
Ang buhay po, aral, inspirasyon na ibinigay po sa atin ni Dr. Jose Rizal ay talagang napakahalaga pa rin po sa kasalukuyan po nating panahon. No? At gawin po sana natin itong giya, gawin po nating sandigan, no, sa atin pong pagharap sa buhay, paglilingkod, at sabihin po natin yung pakikipagkapwa-tao.
The NHCP also launched the Makarizal Art Exhibit at the Jose Rizal Museum in Fort Santiago, Manila, featuring 10 artworks by several artists from Art Philippines.
May ilang artists ang nag-donate ng kanilang mga obra since last year ng National Art Fair for Jose Rizal noong 2022. So parang nag-decide ang museum na i-house yung 10 paintings ng 10 prolific artists natin today dito sa museum, which will be a part of the official list ng collections ng museum from this year.
Bali po yung inspiration ko dito, parang ano lang siya eh, parang more on what ifs. Parang what if kung boy si Rizal ngayon, ano yung mga pwede niyang maging katanungan or pwede niyang masabi sa nangyayari sa bansa. What if ano yung pinupost ni Rizal sa, ano, let's say sa Instagram.
The exhibit at Fort Santiago will last until September 19. That is Datu, ABS-CBN News.
This just in, ABS-CBN's multi-awarded and longest-running noontime show, It's Showtime, has found a new home in rival GMA7's free-to-air TV network, GTV. It's Showtime will air on GTV beginning July 1st. The move comes as the show's contract with TV5 expires at the end of June. In a statement, ABS-CBN thanked TV5 Chairman Manny Pangilinan for bringing It's Showtime to a wider audience. It's Showtime has been entertaining kapamilyas or ABS-CBN audiences for over a decade now. Aside from the chemistry of the hosts such as Vice Ganda and Ann Curtis, the hit show is known for segments like its singing competition, Tawag ng Tanghalan. It's Showtime airs on the Kapamilya channel, Kapamilya Online Live, A2Z Channel 11, and now GTV from Mondays to Saturday. A massive search operation underway to locate a submarine that went missing on the way to explore the wreckage of the Titanic. U.S. and Canadian ships and planes are now scouring the waters off southeastern Canada for any sign of the vessel. The U.S. Coast Guard said one pilot and four passengers are on board the submersible. Among them, British billionaire Hamish Harding. The vessel lost contact nearly 2 hours after it began diving towards the wreckage site.
We understand from the operator of the vessel that the vessel was designed with a 96-hour sustainment capability if there was an emergency on board. And so we're using that time, making the best use of every moment of that time to locate the vessel. Right now, our focus is getting on as much capability into the area as we can and understanding that full capability of those assets that are being deployed. Our aerial assets that are being deployed have the capability to do both visual and radar searches, and the Canadian's asset had the ability to drop sonar buoys and listen. And so we're using all that information to improve our search capability.
Soaring temperatures claim more lives in two northern Indian states, with temperatures reaching 43.5 degrees Celsius. Local media report nearly 170 people have now died in Bihar and Uttar Pradesh. India's meteorological department issued a red alert warning last week for extreme heat in some regions. The government is investigating the cause of the death, saying there is no concrete evidence yet they are tied to the weather.